Good morning students. Last time we have started topic number 14, biomolecules, in which we have completed carbohydrates. Now we are going to see next point, types of proteins. Depending upon the molecular shape, proteins are classified into two types. First is globular protein. Molecules of globular proteins have spherical shape. This shape results from coiling around of the polypeptide chain of protein. Globular proteins are usually soluble in water. For example, insulin, egg albumin, serum albumin, leguminin, that is proteins present in the pulses. Now second, fibrous proteins. Molecules of fibrous proteins have elongated rod-like shape. This shape is the result of holding the polypeptide chain of protein parallel to each other. Hydrogen bonds and disulfide bonds are responsible for this shape. Fibrous proteins are insoluble in water. For example, keratin present in hair, nail, wool. Then myosin proteins present in the muscle. Now we are going to see structure of proteins. Proteins are responsible for a variety of functions in organisms. Proteins of hair, muscle, skin give shape to the structure, while enzymes are proteins which catalyze physiological reactions. This diverse function of protein can be understood by studying the four-level structure of proteins, namely primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure, and quaternary structure of proteins. Now, first we are going to see primary structure of protein. Primary structure of protein is the sequence of constituent alpha amino acid residue linked by peptide bonds. Any change in the sequence of alpha amino residues results in the different proteins. Primary structure of protein is represented by writing the three-letter symbol of alpha amino acids residue as per their sequence in the concerned protein. The symbols are separated by dashes. According to the conventions, the N-terminal amino acid residue as written at the left and the C-terminal of alpha amino acid residue at the right end. Now here, representation of structural formula. Now there are two ways. Now in this case, this is written as NHCHRC double bond ONH. Now this is first alpha amino acid, then this is second alpha amino acid, this is third, and this is fourth, and so on. That is, it is a polypeptide chain possessing number of n numbers of CONH linkage, that is peptide linkage. This is the representation by structural formula. That is, direct here alkyl group, NH2 group or CO group are represented. Now, second way of representation of structure of protein by representation with amino acid symbol. Now, this is ALA, that is alanine. Now, it is glycine. In this way, this is N-terminal and this is the C-terminal or polypeptide chain. And these alpha amino acids are written or they are attached to each other and they are represented by writing the three-letter symbol which are bonded to each other. Now we are going to see secondary structure of protein. The three-dimensional arrangement of localized region of protein chain is called secondary structure of protein. Hydrogen bonding between NH proton of one amide linkage and CO oxygen another give rise to the secondary structure. That is, in case of the secondary structure, primary structure, that is polypeptide of one chain attached to the polypeptide chain of the second by hydrogen bonding. Two types of secondary structures commonly found in protein are called alpha helix and beta pleated sheet. Now we are going to see side by side alpha helix and beta pleated sheet. Now first we are going to see alpha helix or alpha helical structure. The alpha helix forms when a polypeptide chain twists into a right-handed or clockwise spiral. Some characteristic features of alpha helical structures of protein are: each turn of the helix has 3.6 amino acids. A CO group of one amino acid is hydrogen bonded to NH group of the fourth amino acid along the chain. Hydrogen bonds are parallel to the axis of the helix, while R group extended outward from the helix core. Myosin in muscle and alpha keratin in hair are the proteins with almost entire alpha helical secondary structure. Now this is the backbone of alpha helix. Now here this is NHCR CO NH, again here CHR CO NH. Now here this is the alpha helical structure of the protein, in which this oxygen atom of CO group form the hydrogen bonding with the hydrogen atom attached to the nitrogen atom. This is the hydrogen bonding, and this hydrogen bonding is formed in between 3.6 amino acids. Now here this is the hydrogen bonding. Now here also hydrogen bonding, that is CO, oxygen atom of CO group forms hydrogen bonding with the hydrogen atom of the NH group, and here this partial hydrogen bonding is formed, and thus this alpha helical structure is obtained. Now these hydrogen bonds are parallel to the axis of helix, while R group extended outward from the helix, and therefore this alpha helical structure observed in the myosin in muscle and alpha keratin in the hair. Now we are going to see the second type of structure, secondary structure, that is beta pleated sheet. The secondary structure is called beta pleated sheet when two or more polypeptide chains called strands line up side by side. The beta pleated sheet structure of protein consists of extended strands of polypeptides. That is, this is the primary structure of protein, that is polypeptides, held together by a hydrogen bonding. That is, here in beta pleated sheet structure of protein, which consists of extended strands of polypeptides chain held together by a hydrogen bonding. The characteristic of beta pleated sheet structures are: the carbonyl or CO group and NH group bonds lie in the plane of the sheet. Hydrogen bonding occurs between the NH and CO group of nearby amino acid residues in the neighboring chain. The R group are oriented above and below the plane of the sheet. The beta pleated sheet arrangement is favored by amino acids with small R groups. Most proteins have regions of alpha helix and beta pleated sheet, in addition to other random regions that cannot be characterized by either of this secondary structure. For example, spider dragline silk protein is strong due to beta pleated sheet region, yet elastic due to the alpha helical region in it. That is, in the silk protein there is presence of beta pleated sheet and alpha helical region also. Now this is the structure of beta pleated sheet in secondary structure of protein. Now this is one polypeptide chain and this is the second polypeptide chain. These two chains lie side by side and there is formation of hydrogen bonding takes place like this. That is, the carbonyl oxygen of one polypeptide chain forms weak hydrogen bonding with the hydrogen atom attached to nitrogen atom of second polypeptide chain, and in this way the hydrogen bonding is formed, and this is the beta pleated sheet of secondary structure. Now we are going to see tertiary structure of proteins. The three-dimensional shape adopted by the entire polypeptide chain of a protein is called as its tertiary structure. It is the result of folding of the chain in the particular manner that the structure is itself stabilized and also has attractive interaction with the aqueous environment of the cell. The globular protein and fibrous proteins represent two major molecular shapes resulting from the tertiary structure. The force that stabilizes a particular tertiary structure include hydrogen bonding, dipole attraction due to polar bonds in the side chain, electrostatic attraction due to ionic groups like COO or NH3 in the side chain, and also London dispersal forces. Finally, disulfide bonds formed by oxidation of nearby SH group in cysteine residues. This SH is present in cysteine, are the covalent bond which stabilizes the tertiary structure. Now these are the tertiary structure of the protein. Now here, look here, here there is presence of secondary structure. This tertiary structure is combination of primary structure of protein, secondary structure of protein. Now here this primary structure of protein is also present. Then here alpha helical structure which is present in secondary structure is also present, that is this alpha helical structure. And this beta plated structure which is present in secondary protein is also present. And these structures combine together by various types of forces, that is disulfide bond. Now here there is presence of disulfide bond, or by the electrostatic force of attraction, or in London dispersion forces, or by the hydrogen bonding. And thus this tertiary structure of protein is the combination of primary structure and secondary structure of protein to form a tertiary structure. Now quaternary structure of protein. When two or more polypeptide chains with folded tertiary structures come together into one protein complex, the resulting shape is called quaternary structure of the protein. That is, this quaternary structure of protein is formed from two or more polypeptide chains with folded tertiary structure which comes together into one protein complex, and thus the resulting shape is called a quaternary structure of the protein. Each individual polypeptide chain is called a subunit of the overall protein. For example, hemoglobin consists of four subunits called heme, held together by intermolecular forces in a compact three-dimensional shapes. Hemoglobin can do its function of oxygen transport only when all the four subunits are together. Figure summarizes the four levels of protein structure. This is alpha amino acid, that is, this is the primary structure of protein. Then this is beta pleated sheet, and this is alpha helical structure, this is the secondary structure. Now this is beta pleated sheet and alpha helical structure, that is combination of beta pleated sheet and alpha helical structure gives rise to tertiary structure. And this is quaternary structure which possesses multiple units of tertiary structures. Now next point we are going to see is denaturation of protein. Now high temperature, acid, base and even agitation can disturb the non-covalent interaction responsible for specific shape of protein. This is denaturation of protein. Denaturation is the process by which molecular shape of protein changes without breaking the amide or peptide bonds that form the primary structure. Denaturation results in disturbing the secondary, tertiary and quaternary structure of protein. This causes change in properties of protein and the biological activity is often lost. For example, globular proteins are typically folded with hydrophobic side chain in the interior and polar residues on the outside, and thereby are water soluble. Denaturation exposes the hydrophobic region of globular protein and makes them water soluble. Now here it is the example of coiled globular protein. In this coiled globular protein undergo denaturation, it forms loose coil and loops. like structure. Enzymes. Next point we are going to see enzymes. This is the third type of biomolecule. A very large number of chemical reactions take place in our bodies. These are brought about at the physiological pH of 7.4 and the body temperature of 37 degrees Celsius with the help of biological catalyst called enzymes. That is, enzymes are biological catalyst which carries out various types of physiological reactions. For example, insulin, an enzyme secreted by pancreas, controls blood sugar level. Present in saliva, hydrolyzes starch. Chemically, enzymes are proteins. Every living cell contains at least 1000 different enzymes. These enzymes are very particular in their action. Most enzymes catalyzes only one reaction or one group of similar reaction. Thus, enzyme catalyze is highly specific. Enzymes that catalyzes hydrolysis of amide will not work on the ester or acetyl. Now we are going to see mechanism of enzyme catalysis. Action of an enzyme on a substrate is described as lock and key mechanism. Mechanism of this enzyme is like lock and key mechanism. Accordingly, the enzymes has active site on its surface. A substrate molecule can attach to this active site only if it has the right size and shape. Once in the active site, the substrate is held in the correct orientation to react and forms a product of reaction. The products leave the active site and the enzyme is then ready to act as catalyst again. Formation of enzyme substrate complex has very low activation energy. That is how the rate of the reaction is very high. Some enzymes are so efficient that one enzyme molecule can catalyze the reaction of 10,000 substrate molecule in 1 second. Several enzymes have been isolated from organisms such as bacteria, purified and crystallized, and amino acid sequence of many of them have been determined. In many industrial processes, specific reactions are carried out by use of enzymes extracted from organism and also by use of new enzyme made using genetic engineering. Now this is the mechanism of enzyme action. Now this is substrate molecule. This is enzyme and this is the active site. Now this substrate can fit into this active site. Then only the reaction of this enzyme is carried out. That is, this enzyme can catalyze the substrate. Now this is the active site and this substrate molecule can fit into the active site of this substrate, active site of this enzyme. Now when this substrate fit into the active site of this enzyme, then here formation of enzyme substrate complex takes place. And then here formation of product takes place. This is the product and this enzyme remains as it is. And therefore we can say that some enzymes are so efficient that one enzyme molecule can catalyze the reaction of 10,000 substrate molecule in 1 second. That is, one enzyme molecule can convert 10,000 substrate into the product. Now last point, industrial applications of enzyme catalysis. Some examples of industrial application of enzyme catalysis are conversion of glucose to sweet tasting fructose using glucose isomer. Second, manufacture of new antibiotics using penicillin G acylase. Manufacture of laundry detergents using proteases. Manufacture of esters used in cosmetics using genetically engineered enzyme. Thank you.